Today, at the first inaugural Spinal CSF Leak Bridging the Gap Symposium, we come together not just in the spirit of learning, but in the spirit of understanding. Our assembly is unique. We gather as clinicians, researchers, and patients, all driven by a shared commitment to shed light on the accurate diagnosis and effective treatment of this condition. Today, we inaugurate a new chapter in medicine with this conference. We are a unique confluence of patients and healthcare providers, all propelled by a shared dedication to demystifying and treating CSF leaks. We've all been enthralled by the recent advances in radiology, which have provided us with the visual evidence of these leaks, opening new vistas in diagnosis and care. Yet, let us not overlook the profound clinical insights that are woven into the very fabric of our patients' experiences. The stories they share are not mere narratives. They are rich with vital information that can enhance our clinical acumen and our understanding of this disease. We stand united in the face of a condition that has for too long left many feeling isolated within the very system meant to heal them. Today, we turn a new leaf. We are not just sharing space. We are actively weaving a tapestry of trust and respect where the courage of our patients to share their narratives is met with the profound respect and earnest attention it deserves. In the echoes of their experiences, we find more than stories. We discover the beating heart of medicine. Let us channel the spirit of Sir William Osler, who famously said, "Listen to the patient. They are telling you the diagnosis." Today, we listen not only to diagnose, but to learn, to connect, and reaffirm our oath to do no harm. I ask that as providers, we acknowledge the uniqueness of today's CME opportunity to listen to and learn from our patient lectures. Many of these patients have felt vulnerable and unheard during their diagnosis, treatment, or aftercare. And today, as providers, we are inverting the power structure embedded in the patient-doctor relationship and listening to what they, our patients, have to teach us about living with this disease. This conference is a testament to our collective resolve to foster an environment where every voice is heard, every story is honored, and every experience is a step towards enlightenment. On behalf of all providers speaking and in attendance today, I ask that we pledge to embrace the vulnerability of our patient speakers, both today and moving forward, with the dignity and earnestness it warrants. I'm confident that by the end of this conference, we will have nurtured a deeper, more empathetic understanding of this condition, one that resonates with the shared humanity at the core of our practice. So, with a commitment to both learn and support, I warmly welcome you all. Thank you for your presence, your courage, and your invaluable contributions.